in by mistake. I love how we wrote my life, and I love how we seized my heart. So I fall to my knees and I say that I'm grateful when every morning starts. So I don't thank my lucky stars, 'cause that's not where my blessings are.
Hey boys and girls, you know what time it is, because it is Saturday afternoon, and that means it's time for our virtual youth church service here at Allen Temple. I'm the Reverend Kevin Aldridge, your youth pastor, excited as always to be here. And man, we are getting closer and closer to Easter each and every week. And I know you guys were asking last year a whole bunch of questions about Easter and what it means and where did the Easter bunny and all of that stuff come from. So just stay tuned. I'm going to have all of that for you guys in a couple of weeks when we do our Easter service, and you guys will get all of that good stuff then. But in the meantime, I'm excited about the lesson that we've got for you this week. I hope you've had a blessed week, first of all, and that you've taken at least a little time out of your week to pray to God, maybe read some scripture, and try to get a little closer to Him. In fact, boys and girls, we ought to do that every day. We shouldn't just wait for these Saturday videos to start thinking about God, but we should make God a part of our daily routine. Just like eating breakfast, lunch, and dinner, we ought to pray to God throughout the day. We ought to make sure that we're experiencing Him in some way, shape, or form. And this is a great time of year to do it, when we're most thankful about the sacrifice that God made for us on Easter, on Good Friday, and rising from the grave on Easter Sunday. This is a big time of year for us as Christians. And so what better time to rededicate ourselves to God and spending time with Him and getting to know more about Him. All right. Well, with that, we're going to go ahead and get into the service for this morning, and I'll be back a little bit later on in the video with our scripture lesson and our sermonette for this week. So boys and girls, as always on these Saturday videos, we got a great Sunday school lesson planned for you guys this week. So I want you to sit back, relax, but keep your eyes and your ears open, because I don't want you to miss the great message we've got for you today from our Sunday school. So I'll turn it over to our teachers, and I'll be back in just a minute.
My lucky stars, 'cause that's not where my blessings are.
Hi, this is lesson number 3 for March 20th. Do what is right. And this lesson comes from Kings chapter 22, verses 14 through 20. God's word is the guide that we use for measuring our lives. Today we will learn about what happens when the people don't have God's word as their measurement and thus do their own thing. So we're going to read what's it all about. Crystal was humming with excitement. Mrs. Acklin, her mom, was teaching her how to make chocolate cake to take to school for her class party. Are you sure you followed the directions? Mrs. Acklin asked. I'm sure, Mama. I read the directions very carefully, Crystal replied. Okay, then you can pour the batter into the pans and put the cake in the oven. 25 minutes later, Crystal went to the kitchen to check on the cake. Mama, Mama, come! The cake exploded all over the oven. Crystal cried. Oh, Mama, I can't do anything right, she sobbed. Calm down, Crystal, Mrs. Acklin said. Here, let's look at the recipe again, she said measuringly. As Mrs. Acklin and Crystal were going over the recipe, Crystal realized her mistake. Oh, Mama, I used 3 tablespoons of baking powder instead of 3 teaspoons, and that's what caused the mess. Have you ever been in a situation similar to Crystal's? Discuss with your parents.
My lucky stars, 'cause that's not where my blessings are.
Hey, boys and girls, it's time for our scripture lesson this week. And our scripture lesson can be found in the Gospel according to John, the 2nd chapter. And we're going to be reading verses 13 through 16. And this is going to form the basis for our sermonette this week. So we're going to take a couple minutes to read that scripture. And in John, the 2nd chapter, beginning at verse 13, it says, "When it was almost time for the Jewish Passover, Jesus went up to Jerusalem. In the temple courts, he found men selling cattle, sheep, and doves, and others sitting at tables exchanging money. So he made a whip out of cords and drove all from the temple area, both sheep and cattle. He scattered the coins of the money changers and overturned their tables. To those who sold doves, he said, "Get these out of here. How dare you turn my father's house into a market?" May the Lord add a blessing to the readers, hearers, and doers of his holy word. Boys and girls, I want to talk to you for just a few minutes this afternoon about it's time to clean house. About it's time to clean house. So I bought a few items with me here today that, you know, maybe some of you guys might use to clean up around your house every now and again. I bought some window cleaner here with me today to sometimes you put that on the window to clean your windows, and of course you're going to need some paper towels to be able to do that, to wipe some things down or maybe wipe up some spills or some other things that you made. Brought a little Clorox disinfecting cleaner. You know, maybe you spray this on your kitchen counter or in your bathrooms, around the sink, or maybe even the toilet to get all of the bacteria and dirt out of those things to clean it up. And of course, we got our own trusty Dawn dishwashing liquid. Some of you guys are old enough now where you're probably doing dishes, or maybe you're lucky enough to have a dishwasher in your house. I don't like to do dishes, so I bought a dishwasher a few years ago, so I don't have to worry about that. But maybe you do. Maybe you you have to do some dishes at home yourself. But these are just some of the cleaning supplies that we use in our own house. So I wanted to ask you a question today. How do you know when it's time to clean house at your home? How do you know when it's time to clean house? Well, here are some few things that might give you a clue that it's time for you to clean house at your house. It might be time to clean your house when you walk through your kitchen and your feet kind of stick to the floor. That might be a good sign that it's time to clean house. Or maybe it might be time to clean your room when your mom comes in to wake you up in the morning to get to school and she can't find you because there's so much junk in your room that you just kind of are buried underneath it. Or maybe it's time for you to clean the windows in your house when they're dirty enough that somebody can come by and wipe, write "wash me" on your windows. Some of you guys have seen that on windows, or maybe even a dirty car. If you can do that, then it's probably time to clean up a little bit. Lastly, if you got enough dust bunnies under your bed that maybe you could start a bunny farm of your own, it's probably a good sign that it's time for you to do a little house cleaning. Can we all agree on that? Amen, amen. Well, you know, one day Jesus had decided that he needed to do a little house cleaning of his own. You know, he had come to Jerusalem for the Passover holiday, which we're about to enter that season now as we're getting close to Easter. And the Passover was a very religious season for Jews back in that time. And Jesus visited the temple while he was there in Jerusalem. And when he went into the temple, he saw all kinds of people doing things that they shouldn't have been doing in the temple. There were people who were selling cattle and other animals and doves, and there were money changers in there who were making money off of people who were trying to exchange and trade money so that they could make their offerings. And Jesus saw all of this stuff going on, and it made him very angry. In fact, it made Jesus so angry that the Bible tells us that he made a whip out of cords, and he used that whip to run all of the cattle and the sheep and the doves out of the temple. And then on top of that, he took the tables where the money changers had all of their money, and he turned them over, scattering the coins all over the table. And he said to the money changers and the people who were selling these, he said, "How dare you dirty up my father's house by turning it into a market?" That a temple was a place of reverence for God, and here they were defiling it, doing all manner of things that they weren't supposed to be doing. They were actually dirtying up the temple, if you will. So Jesus had to clean it out. Well, boys and girls, we can take from that message that we have to do a little cleaning up too every now and again, because the Bible tells us that our bodies are temples of God, that God, the Spirit of God, dwells within our bodies. So occasionally, boys and girls, we have to do a little cleaning up of our temples. We've got to clean up ourselves. And so when we do cleaning, we got to get rid of some of the dirty parts of our lives, some of the dirty things that exist in our hearts and in our minds, and maybe even sometimes in our mouth. We have to learn how to clean that stuff up. So if we're speaking disrespectfully or not really using good language, I hope nobody out there is using bad language, but if you are, that's something that you ought to clean up, especially around this time of year where we're talking about Lent, a period of sacrifice. You remember we covered that a couple of weeks ago in one of our videos, that Lent is a time of sacrifice, a time of getting ourselves prepared for God. So when we're getting ourselves prepared for God, sometimes we got to clean up our temple. Sometimes we got to clean out some of the messed up ways of thinking and thoughts that we have, and try to think more like God thinks and how Jesus would want us to think. Sometimes we got to clean up our behavior, start acting better, start being more respectful, doing the things that we're supposed to do, honoring our mothers and fathers, and not bearing false witness or saying false statements about people and doing those sorts of things. We've got to clean up our hearts. Because one of the things that we don't want Jesus coming after us with a whip of cords. Amen. Amen. So we want to be able to clean up our temples ourselves. So boys and girls, I want you to take this time as we are preparing ourselves for Easter Sunday to think about what sorts of things do you need to clean up in your life? What kind of dirt do you need to get out of your mind, out of your mouth, and out of your behaviors? And then do your best to try to disinfect, clean it up, so that you can see things clearly and that you can have a temple that is worthy of God's Spirit. Amen. That's my prayer for each of you this week. So that's all I've got this week. Maybe you guys have got some chores to do at home, so I'm going to let you go so you can get busy cleaning up your rooms, or maybe even doing a little dishes or some windows this afternoon. All right. Well, until we meet next time, boys and girls, we're going to close with our YPD benediction, and I pray that God blesses you and keeps you.
Today I'm in a happy place, and I know it didn't happen by mistake. In the name of the Triune God, may the spirit of Christian mission enter in every heart. This we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. I love how he wrote my life, and I love how he sees my heart. So I fall to my knees and I say that I'm